wanted the audience to experience a movie in which they were not sure if the fairy tale elements were real or not, but I was sure. As far as I'm concerned, they're real. So some, not in the way people understand it, but I do think that I happen to believe that fantasy and stories have the same weight in shaping who we are than real things. It is also a movie that, by virtue of the care with which it was made and the idea of making a movie that felt eternal, that it belonged to a tradition of fairy tales, like, it's a movie that I wanted to feel like it's a fairy tale you've heard, and it's a very ancient fairy tale that has been repeated after many generations. I didn't want it to feel new. I wanted it to feel eternal, like it came from a long, long oral tradition, and it has that power, fortunately. We tell ourselves stories about who we are, and we lie to ourselves, and we limit ourselves. And I really think that the movie was about those stories being as real, as palpable reality, and having as much an effect. I think the girl saves so many things. Her presence and her decisions change the world in the real world, change the outcome of the real world. And I think it's really powerful as a message for me, that imaginary world can be more real than what we agree upon as adults. Geography, religion, gender, these are a lot of things that we construct to operate as a society. But they are not real. If you look at geography, it's not real. There are no lines delimiting the U.S. and Mexico. If you take a photo of a satellite, it's just earth and water. And the fact that we accept those boundaries, they're inventions, they're fantasy. I think that Pants is a movie that will connect deeply with some people. Whatever its audience is, I don't care. For example, Crimson Peak, to me, the people that connect with that movie connect very profoundly, but they're not as numerous as the people that connect with Pants or Shape or Water or so forth. But it doesn't matter, but the depth of the connection is what I knew was going to be. I thought this movie could connect long term, like some people will love it. And I had that certainty. And I feel that when a movie connects that deep, there's an element of it that you cannot explain. There's a moment that is like music. That when you hear a song, and I can tell you that's re, mi, you know, do, whatever, the you know, C minor, whatever it is, you know, but the melody makes you feel something very deep. It moves you at a very deep level. There's many, many filmmakers that affect me. You know, they can be Melville, Cocteau, it can be William Wyler, it can be Raoul Walsh, it can be many, 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 many. I'm a cinephile. But there are certain movies that are life-altering for me, that truly embed in me. Terry Gilliam's Brazil embeds in me, and Gilliam is a massive part of my aesthetic. But there's something in Gilliam that I that will always pulsate in my DNA. It's part of my DNA. The Spirit of the Beehive, Victor Erice's movie, completely transformed my life. Los Olvidados by Luis Buñuel completely transformed my life. You know. And Buñuel in general. Buñuel and Hitchcock are the two giants of my life in cinema. I know one thing. In more than a quarter of a century of career, I have never made a movie I wouldn't want to die for, that I would live, so many times I have put my own salary, so many times I have given up my salary, so many times I have paid for an extra day of shoot. And this is because I'm personally involved. The way I see it is I'm an art collector, and I want to buy that piece of art that is that movie because I like it. I want it hanging on my wall, so to speak. And that's what I do. So if I love it with that depth, something of me is going to be there. I can tell you what I do. I plan very, very, very carefully the movies. The fastest I can prep a movie is 6 months. That's the fastest. Normally I take 9 to 12 months to prep a movie, visually and lay it out and all that. I love actors. I love camera work. I love telling a sequence without words, just camera and sound, you know? But you don't think about, I'm going to do this, blah, 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 you know? Well, I think that when you come to a movie, you come to a movie with everything you are. So, you where you come from is extremely important. And part of it is where we come from, what music we listen to, what movies we watched. I can tell you very sort of broadly that the melodrama I grew up with in Mexico is in my movies. This sense of melodrama that came from watching Pedro Infante is in my movies. The idea of loving the monster with a certain innocence comes from watching wrestler movies, wrestler / horror Mexican movies. The way I react to music, and I'm capable of singing at the least provocation, it's in my movies. You know, the love of these things, the idea of family, the idea of friendship, the idea of human relationships, the idea of oppression, the distrust for institutions, all that is Mexican. You know, so Alfonso and Alejandro, same thing.